Hello. In this video, we're going to submit a work schedule change for an employee. I'm going to show you how to log into your portal, find the work schedule change form link, fill out the form, and submit. It's that easy. Let's go through it step by step. Timekeepers and managers can submit a work schedule change form through their My Northridge portal. Using Chrome or Internet Explorer, log into the My Northridge portal through the CSUN website. Make sure you're on the tab that says Staff. Then, look for the pagelet HR/Manager or HR/Timekeeper, Time and Attendance. You're going to click on the link that says Work Schedule Change Form. If your time and attendance tab looks different from mine, or it's in a different location on the page, that's okay, as long as it says Work Schedule Change Form. If you don't see the link, or you don't see the tab at all, you'll need to talk to an established timekeeper, or work with HR to get timekeeper permissions. Let's go ahead and open up the request. If your form doesn't look like this, it might be because of your browser. Try using a different browser. With the work schedule change form now open, you can input your employee's CSUN ID, then click or tab out of the field. The rest of their information should fill in for you. If you made a mistake on the ID, you can always clear the form to try again. The fields will turn red when they're cleared, but that's only because they're required before submitting. If the employee has multiple active records, you'll be prompted to select which one this schedule change applies to. Review the active records, then scroll to the right to select. For now, let's submit a schedule change for Maddie Matador. When you scroll down, you'll see instructions and examples. Read these carefully, especially if it's your first time. You can click on each example to expand them. For this work schedule change, we want to move Maddie to a 4-10 schedule starting March 3rd. That's a Sunday. He'll be working 10 hours a day, 4 days a week. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. He's not scheduled to work the other days, so we're going to put zeros. Note that each of these fields is required, so you'll need to put a value in each of them, even if it's a zero. Pay extra attention to the start date of your work schedule change. Most work schedule changes should take effect on a Sunday. That's the start of a work week. If I made this 4-10 schedule effective Tuesday, and they're still on a standard schedule Monday for 8 hours, that's 48 hours that week. We don't want that. Let's move it back to Sunday, which is the start of our work week. 40 hours. That's better. Now that we're sure the scheduled hours and the schedule change start date are problem-free, let's add a description for clarity. 4-10, Tuesday through Friday. Finally, if we know that this is a temporary schedule, we can also put in a row for whatever schedule comes after. All the way on the right, you'll see an Add button. You might need to scroll to see it. Go ahead and click it, and a new row will appear. Let's return him to a standard schedule starting Sunday, May 26th. If it turns out you don't need the extra rows, go ahead and remove them using the button on the right. The next section is contact information. If you, as the timekeeper or manager, are filling this out for someone else, and they're the one to contact in case there are questions on the form, go ahead and put that contact information here. Let's review the information at the bottom, make sure it all matches up, and then we'll click Submit. You should see a confirmation page. After a few minutes, you'll receive an email saying your work schedule change form was submitted. Now, if you're the employee's manager submitting this request, it'll go straight to payroll. Otherwise, the manager will receive an email with instructions on how to approve the request. That's covered in the next video. Once the form has been processed, the timekeeper, manager, and employee get an email saying the form has been processed. If you have any other questions, you can email hrdocuments@csun.edu. Thanks for watching.